Hi everyone, it's Gus from Pi My Life Up, and today I'll be going through how to set up the Apache web server on the Raspberry Pi. Apache is one of the most popular web servers available and is used in web stacks around the world. By default, Apache serves HTML files using HTTP and HTTPS. Additional modules such as PHP allow you to serve dynamic content. In this video, I will be walking you through the steps to setting up Apache, installing PHP, and creating a basic Apache virtual host file. To get started, first open the terminal on your Raspberry Pi or SSH to it. First, update the package list by entering sudo apt update. Now let's update all the out-of-date packages by entering sudo apt upgrade. If prompted, enter Y to upgrade the packages. Now let's install Apache by entering sudo apt install apache2-y. Once that is installed, we now have a basic Apache web server up and running. Let's first get the IP address of our Raspberry Pi by entering hostname -I. Our IP address is the first one in the list. Now go to your favorite web browser and enter the IP address we just got. In my case, it is 192.168.0.15. You should see the default Apache page. Now go back to the terminal, as we need to make some permission changes so we can make edits to the files within the /var/www/html directory without using the root user. To do this, enter sudo usermod -a -G www-data$user all in uppercase. This command will add our current user to the www-data group, which is the default group for Apache. Next, we need to give ownership to all the directories to the www-data group. You can do this by entering sudo chown-r-f-www-data::\var/www/html-r makes the command recursive, and -f suppresses any messages from the command. Now let's update the permissions of the directories and files so the owner and group have read, write, and execute permissions. You can do this by entering sudo chmod-r-770/var/www/html. Now restart by entering sudo reboot. This will ensure our changes come into effect. Now let's test our permissions by creating a file. So enter /var/www/html/test.html. In here, simply write hello world with 3 exclamation marks. Then save and exit by pressing Ctrl X, then Y, and then enter. Open up your favorite web browser. Go to our web server. In my case, it is at 192.68.0.15. and reference the test HTML page. So in my case, it's /test.html. As you can see, that all worked correctly. Now let's install PHP and some PHP modules. To do this, enter the following command: sudo apt install php8.2 libapache2-mod-php8.2 php8.2-mb-string, php8.2-mysql, php8.2-curl, php8.2-gd, php8.2-zip-y. Once that is finished, PHP is now installed. However, we need to test that PHP installed correctly. So let's create an example PHP script. To do this, enter /var/www/html/example.php. In this file, write the following PHP script: less than sign, question mark, PHP, then on a new line, echo, double quotes, today's date is, double quotes, dot date, bracket, single quote, capital Y, hyphen M, hyphen D, capital H, colon, I, colon, S, single quote, bracket, semicolon. This script will simply print out the current date. Save and exit by pressing Ctrl X, then Y, then Enter. Now go to your web browser and navigate to the example PHP script. In my case, this is 192.168.0.15/example.php. As you can see, the PHP is rendering correctly as it is outputting our string and today's date. Lastly, I will quickly run through virtual hosts. Virtual hosts allow you to run multiple configurations on the same server. This is a great way to handle multiple websites. To start, we will need to create a config file within the site's available directory in our Apache folder. Replace example.com with your own domain name. Sudo nano slash etc slash apache2 slash sites hyphen available slash example.com.conf. Now in here, write less than virtual host star colon 80 greater than. Now this line designates the start of a virtual host and that this virtual host should listen to port 80. Port 80 is the default port for HTTP. Now for next lines, indent them 4 spaces. Server name, example.com. Server alias, www.example.com. The first of these directives, called server name, designates the base domain. This server name is used to match the virtual host to a domain name. The second directive, server alias, defines additional domain names that will be matched as if they were the base domain name. Now enter document root slash var slash www slash example.com slash public underscore HTML. The document root directive defines the directory where all the files will be served from. Now enter error log dollar sign curly bracket apache underscore log underscore dir curly bracket slash example.com underscore error dot log and then custom log dollar sign curly bracket apache underscore log underscore dir slash example.com underscore access.log combined. These two directives are where we specify the locations where we want our log files to be stored. Lastly, close our virtual host by entering less than slash virtual host greater than. Once you're happy with the file, save it by pressing Ctrl X, then Y, and then Enter. Now we need to create the document root directory and ensure we have the correct permissions. To do this, enter sudo mkdir hyphen p slash var slash www slash example.com slash public underscore html. Now enter sudo chown hyphen capital R www hyphen data colon www hyphen data slash var slash www slash example.com slash public underscore html. And one final command, sudo chmod hyphen r 770 slash var slash www slash example.com slash public underscore html. Now that is all done, we can now activate our virtual host. To do this, we'll be entering a command that creates a symlink for our config file between the site's available directory and the site's enabled directory. To activate our virtual host, enter sudo a2ensite example.com.conf. Once done, simply reload Apache by entering sudo systemctl reload Apache 2. I hope you now have Apache running on your Raspberry Pi without any issues. If you liked this tutorial, please hit like and subscribe. Until next time, have a good one.